Hey everybody in YouTube land, this is Jackie from Endtime 777. This is my second attempt to do this part of the video. However, it was cut off. I did it in three segments. The second segment is where I began saying that I was interrupted. And it's funny that I said the devil doesn't like us doing these things because I can't seem to upload the first one. So this is my second attempt, and if some things overlap, I apologize. Has anybody taken a look around and look at everything that's going on in the world right now? Times are changing, and it's changing in a hurry. So the first thing I want to tell you is I implore you to not roll over. Don't give in to the evil that is coming upon this world. The time has now come. It is here, where bad is good and good is bad. Take a look at TV and the way that they're mocking of the Christianity religion, and how if anyone mocks Christianity, it's not a big deal, but if they mock Islam, then we have a huge problem on our hands. Like I said, things are changing. This is my personal motto, and my personal motto is I hate this world and I love my God, and I shall put nothing above my God, not even the wants and the rules of this world. I never thought I would see the day when simply being in disagreement with our government and expressing our opinion based on religious and moral values would be deemed as a crime or a mental disorder. And yes, people, there is a mental disorder. I'll put it up a little later. However, I guess we're there. And therein lies the question, my friends. What path will you take? Now think about this. And realistically answer yourself, because no one on earth knows you better than you. Mind you, I said here on earth. The path you decide to take will most certainly determine your outcome. With that in mind, how will your decision affect those around you and those that you love? And yeah, I write everything down before I put it on YouTube. Okay, so let's discuss each possibility, that possible scenarios of things that could occur. Let's say you make a video about your concern and complete disgust and how your country is being run, like a lot of us do, and the wrong person sees your video and reports you as a possible domestic threat. The feds show up at your doorstep and begin to question you. How will you answer them? And if they want you to go with them, how will you react? Let's say your neighbor reports to the authorities that you own numerous firearms and have a stockpile of ammunition, and they come to your house and want you to release your firearms and ammunition to them. What do you do then? How do you react? The government has now declared it illegal to grow your own garden and have banned the use of your own personal well on your own private property. Wow. You have both of them, and now you are not in compliance with federal law and subject to a fine and jail time. What do you do, and how do you react? The question you first must ask yourself, people, is, are you a leader? You could be and not even know it. Just follow these guidelines and make it a part of your everyday life. I like to follow the leadership principle. And it's L for loyalty to God's words and laws, duty to protect and defend yourself and your family, responsibility to inform the unaware, store for times of trouble, help for the less fortunate and elderly whenever possible, and pray for the lost and for those persecuted, to include yourself. After a while, people, it becomes muscle memory and a part of your everyday life. You'll just do it automatically. That way, when the day comes, and it will come, people, you will react the way you should. Alright, this is the way I believe that the proper way to react to these scenarios are. And you can react however you want. However, the outcome is fully and ultimately your responsibility. And what you do determines your outcome. I believe that if they ask you questions, the federals, you know, the feds and all that, they come to your door, you should openly and honestly answer them, no matter what the consequences to you are. Like I said, remember to use leadership in your responses. If they want to take you, then go with no resistance. And hopefully by now you know your Second Amendment. As long as you are legally owning your firearms, you are correct in your stance. Remember to use leadership as your guide. And if they take you, go. If they find your firearms, let them have them. And remember, God is your guide. Ultimately, people, God is the one that's going to protect you. Okay? Prepping, food storage, is essential. Especially now with food shortages and high prices on the horizon. I need you to study and learn how to become less dependent on the grocery store, which I find is most Americans' problems, because they tend to say, I'm out of milk, I'm going to go down to the grocery store and buy some. But what happens if that grocery store is not available at some point, or the cost of buying that milk and bread and eggs is too high for you? Then what do? Sorry about that, my friends. I was interrupted. I imagine the devil does not like us to do this type of work. As a matter of fact, even someone in my own family, someone that lives in my own household, believes that we are delusional and the things that we believe will not come to pass. But I tell you now, these things will come to pass. It was prophesied many, many thousands of years ago to come to pass, and as you can see around you, things are happening very quickly. So again, I say, remember leadership principles. If they want to put you in jail or fine you for growing food and having your own water, if they catch you, if the Lord allows them to catch you, pay the fine or go to jail, and just remember that God is your guide. Now, all of these scenarios and many more are plausible and possible situations you may find yourself in. The Bible plainly states that persecution is part of what is to come. Expect it, prepare for it, and above all, remember your reward for doing the right thing. Avoid violence at all costs. I'll say it again. Avoid violence at all costs. You may protect yourself and you may protect your family. However, you must remain passive. Now, I want to know what kind of Christians you are. So you say you're a Christian. What kind of Christian are you? Are you a part-timer? Which does you absolutely no good, by the way. Are you an aggressive Christian? Which also does you no good. Or are you an absolute passive Christian that stands back and lets everything happen? Now, don't confuse the two when I tell you to be passive. Okay? Don't confuse the two. Where do you fall, my friend? Let's take a look at the definition of Christian. Examples of forms of persecution around the world, and especially in America. You just take a look around you. Look at all the videos you've seen. What is the atheist community saying about Christians? And what about Homeland Security? Let's take a look at what the atheist community is saying. They call it Christ psychosis. I'll throw up the definition for that. I'll also throw up the definition for the word terrorist and how Homeland Security views us, the Christian community. Now again, I ask you, what is a part-time Christian? Are they in danger of persecution and detention? Here's my example of part-time. Okay, my friends, what's an aggressive Christian? And what will happen to them? And what is a passive Christian? Are they in danger? What does Jesus say about being passive? So all in all, what category do you fall in? Is there an in-between category? I believe absolutely there is an in-between category. If you don't know your rights as a citizen, study up on your rights as a citizen. Be aware of your rights as a citizen. Stand up and don't be aggressive, but passive in approach. Who do you prefer to answer to? This is the biggest question of all people. Who do you prefer to answer to, God or the authorities? Whose law do you hold? Do you hold our Father in Heaven's laws? Or do you abide by the laws of the land? Now, the Bible plainly states that you are to follow all laws of the authority, no matter how horrendous. But it also talks about what will happen to the authorities and the governments if they fail to take care of their people. All you have to do is read, people. Read the Bible. It tells you exactly what will happen to them. And now I must speak out to them because this is what I need to do. God forbid that the governments of our world begin persecuting those that follow Jesus Christ. I can only implore to you that this design and this plan that you have, that you want to kill the majority of the people of the world, I can only implore that you cease this plan. Because I guarantee you the Lord will not allow it to continue. He will not allow it. So I just want to tell everybody, this is the way I've been feeling lately. I've been pondering what it means to be a Christian, how we should act and how we should react to certain situations. And I believe the answer is only in Christ, and do as He would do and act as He would act. I feel right now an anxiety within me that's building, and I don't know if many of you feel this, but I do. I feel that all I'm doing is passing time, waiting for something to happen. Like I'm expecting something big to occur. I don't know when. I don't know where. I'm not a prophet. All I can tell you is I have that feeling inside of me that's growing every day. It's an anxiety as if I know something is about to occur. I don't know what it is. Maybe some of you do. Maybe some of you have ideas. Maybe some of you have had visions. If so, feel free to put it below and express how you feel about things that are going on right now and how you feel that things might be occurring in the world today and how it will affect you and your family. Here is what I'm doing for my family. Recently, God has blessed me very well with a job that finally I'm able to add to my storage of food and necessities in case something does occur. I am not going to build up my firearms arsenal. I'm not going to do that. I have what I have. Hope I never have to use it. It's one thing I've always prayed, that I would never have to use it in that type of manner. And I believe that if I request that of my Father, He will allow me not to have to ever resort to any type of thing such as that. I can only hope and pray, because a lot of you will sit there and say, I will say no. I will definitely turn away the mark. I definitely will not allow them to come and gather my firearms or take away my garden without a fight. And then some of you will say, you know what, I'll let them do it. And then your reactions will be totally opposite from what you say right now. So please don't put down below that I will not, because you don't know what you're going to do until that time comes. All you can do is rely on the faith that you have in Jesus Christ, and that the Lord will send His angels here to protect you and to put in your mouth, that is, what you need to say. This is a trying time, folks. A very trying time. I implore you to dig deep into the Word, because the Word is what will protect you, not a bullet. I bless every single one of you that watches my videos. In the name of Yeshua HaMashiach, that He cover you with His mercy and His grace. Have a great day, everyone. Bye-bye.